Welcome back to Initial Weekly's episode 4 featuring Banzer Labs Lithium. So, here we are, Banzer Labs boot menu. So we have live and fail safe and load to RAM, and we have install, text based install, and vast options. I'm gonna go ahead and install Banzer Labs Lithium. I think it's version 2.1, and I know nothing about Banzer Labs, so this should be interesting. I know that they have a good welcome screen. So again, this is the Debian installer, pretty usual. So I just realized that it's based on Debian and not Ubuntu. So anyway, let's just go ahead and set this up real quick. And let me go to Europe, and then let's go to Greece and United States. Yeah, American English. And it's detecting everything, my drives and probably the CD components. Oh, I see that we're running kernel 4.19, which is super old at this point. The latest one is 5.13, I think, yeah. IPv6 auto configuration, and we should now, hopefully when this finishes, there we go. Let's set up the host name. This is gonna be Papa's Banzer Labs VM. We're gonna go ahead and hit continue, local domain continue. And a name, full name for the new user will be me, a username will be me, and let's type in a super secret and secure password and hit continue. And it's now starting up the partitioner. We're gonna use Gadget, use the entire disk, this whole 15 gigabyte hard drive. We're gonna hit continue, and all files in one partition, which is recommended. I see that we have three options. We also have separate /home/var/temp partitions. Okay, I'm gonna select the default one, and finish partitioning, write changes to the disk, yes, and now we should start the actual installation. As you can see here, it's installing the system. I hope that this won't take as long as Kali did, but yeah, be right back. And here we are, Banzer Labs. And let's just boot. Yep. Do we have a splash screen? I don't think so. It doesn't seem like it. Yeah, probably we don't. And here we are on the login screen. And this is a really nice login screen, I have to say. So let's type in my super secret and secure password. And we are still waiting. I hope that the desktop background is the same so that it's seamless, but no, it's not. Okay. So here we are, great, this is the desktop. I'm waiting for a welcome screen. I think there is a script. Yeah, here it is, the welcome script. But what I want to do is that I want to go to preferences and then I open box. No, it's not open box, of course. It's display and a render. And we're gonna change this to a bigger resolution. There we go, apply, boom. And now we also need to change the background, the desktop background, so I'm not sure how you do that. Appearance, probably. And then nothing here, actually. Okay. Oh, wallpaper. Obviously. And let's see what wallpapers we have. Let's get this out of the way. So before sunrise, have this one. This one, ooh, this is nice. This is cool. We have this one. We have this one. This one, ooh, that's nice. And this one, which is also really nice. I'm gonna keep this one. This is not the default, I know, but I'm gonna keep this. And I can see that the conky is not really here, so is there any way to reset? Nope, it doesn't seem like it. So yeah, anyway, let's go through the welcome screen. So, hi, me. Welcome to Banzer Labs Linux. This is an optional post-installation script designed to help you configure your new Linux installation and get the most out of Banzer Labs. You will now be presented with a series of options. You will need your password, so please have it ready. You will also need a working internet connection, so if you have not done so already, please configure your internet connection. If you do not want to run this script now, you can run it later by entering the command bl-welcome in your terminal. Messages will be saved to /home/me/.cast/banzer-welcome/bl.welcome. That's welcome. there's the dot log. Anyway, let's hit enter and go ahead and see what we have. So we need our password. And oh, it says thank you, that's great. So yep. Adding PPAs and stuff. So we need to type I understand. So I understand and hit enter to continue. Update the software sources and upgrade installed packages. Would you like to upgrade? Yes, why not? So we're now gathering updates. And we have quite a lot of updates, so I'm gonna hit yes, and let's see if this is gonna take a long while to actually download. I don't think so, but we have to wait and see. Ooh, finally, this took way longer than it should have. Anyway, I didn't really time-lapse this because the recording crashed halfway through the update, so I'm sorry for that. Bansen Labs Lithium comes with a set of background images, but the wallpaper and other background images were released. So do you want the background images? No, I'm not gonna go through that. And David Backports repository. Well, yes, let's go ahead and enable them. And then press any key to continue. And the Bansen Lab Backports, let's enable them. Press any key to continue. Bluetooth support? No, because this VM and my PC doesn't have Bluetooth. Java support? No, because this VM, I'm not gonna use this. Dropbox, I don't want this. Development packages, no, I don't want them. And thank you for selecting Bansen Labs. Hit the key to finish. And that's it, we're now on Bansen Labs. And the first thing I'm gonna do is go ahead and restart. So logout shutdown, and this button does nothing. Oh, finally, reboot. And let's see the boot time. This shouldn't take that long. Also, while this thing is booting, look what I got. I'm not sure how well you can see this, but yeah. This is an M2 SSD. This is a SATA 3 one, but I'm also waiting for a PCI Express one. I'm gonna return this because it was the wrong one actually. But yeah, I'm definitely gonna check it out and write my opinions on Twitter, so go ahead and follow me there. Anyway, let's type in my super secret and secure password and log in back to Bansen Labs. And I really like this background because it makes all this consistency. Yeah, and the uptime 1 minute per second, so it was around 1.5 minutes, the boot time. And of course we now have to go back and change the display resolution. Okay, and let's also change once again the wallpaper back to this one. There we go. And yeah, here we are. So let's see what we have on the desktop. We have a Conky, which is the system info and also the shortcuts. Super useful, I guess. And it's supposed to be on the top right hand corner, but I just rescaled the screen, so yeah, not the best. It uses only 400 megs, and right down here, as you probably guessed, is the workspace feature, which is okay, I guess. As you can see here, it's scroll enabled. And let's take a look at the shortcut. So Alt F2 says run dialog, so yeah, I almost thought that this was gonna open the GNOME's dialog, but yeah, that's great. Then Alt F3 is the Alt menu. Oh yeah, great. D menu probably it means. Super is the main menu, yep. And then Super and Tab is the client menu. Okay. And Super and T is the terminal. Let's see what terminal we have. And no idea what terminal is. Let's go ahead and install NeoFetch as we do. And type in my super secret password, and I think I typed it wrong. Yep. And while this is going on again, let's go ahead and do a df-h. So as I said, we only, it only uses 3.9 gigabytes, which I think is the lightest distro that I've ever tried personally. And let's see the free what reports. It reports 540 megabytes of RAM being used, but we are also downloading and installing packages right now. But anyway, just finished, so let's launch NeoFetch, and we have a custom logo, which is really nice. This is Bansen Labs GNU/Linux 10.5 Lithium Edition, and it's the general 4.19.0. Wow! And we have 1217 D packages, bus 5.0.3, and it says it's running XFCE with OpenBox, and the theme is BL-Lithium, and the icons are Papyrus, Bansen, Dark, Blue Gray, the Terminal 6 Terminal Emulator. And that's about it. Okay, so that's an interesting combo. let's see what apps we used. And I'm gonna open the menu here this time. So let's see, under accessories we have of course the archive manager, we have BL CLI editor, BL file manager, so let's see what file manager we use. And this should be PCMANFM. No, this is Thunar. Okay, and we have Clippy, Compton, file ma- we have another file manager. This should be Thunar again. Yeah, Thunar. And we also have Screenshot, Terminal Emulator, Thunar File Manager again, Vim, External Emulator, and XFBurn. Development, we don't have a lot. Yeah. Graphics, we have BL Image Viewer, Document Viewer, Ristretto, Multimedia, PN Mixer, VLC Media Player, XFBurn again. Internet, we have Advanced Network Configuration, FileZilla, Firefox CSR, HexChat, Mail Reader Transmission, Web Browser, and X Web Browser. What is web browser and what's X web browser? Let's wait for it to open, but while this is going on, let's see what office we have. We have LibreOffice, and then we have settings and system. Okay, so, oh, everything is a web browser. Okay, let's, okay, it's version 17.9 ESR. That's old, actually. And let's see what the other web browser is. So, X web browser. Is it Firefox? Yep, again, Firefox. That's weird, to be honest with you. Volume control is super plus V. Yep. And task manager is plus H. Super I or L. L, I think. Let's see. Yep, this is the lock screen that has a great lock screen. Oh, okay, this is the lock screen. Okay. Normal stuff. And it goes to reset again. Let's go ahead and change the display once again to a proper resolution. This is not the native resolution of my display, but it's close enough. And yeah, now down here we have another trigger for the main menu, which is the same thing as right clicking the desktop anywhere. And then we have the workspace switcher, volume controls, a clipboard. Then here's this computer. This is probably XFC power manager, network, time, and then the logout shutdown things. Yep. And that's it, basically. I don't have anything else to say about it. It's a lightweight distro based on Debian, and I don't like it. Yeah, it's not really my favorite kind of distro. I think that tomorrow's distro will be much better. And yeah, that's it. I don't have anything else to say. I was super disappointed actually with this one, because I thought that it was gonna be a crazy good distro, that because I remember everyone talking about it, but it's actually not. I guess it's all right if you just want something light, but for me, not really. It's based on Debian, so super old kernel, and yeah, I don't think that would support my computer correctly. But anyway, tell me what you think down in the comments below. This has been Initial Week episode 4 featuring Basnet Labs Lithium. The ISO is version 2.1, and have a good one. Peace out. And it did not install VMware tools package.